Hello and welcome back to Cerulean Skies and Zelda June. I am Rio and I am not playing a Zelda game here, as you can possibly see. I am playing Sable. And the reason I am playing Sable is one, I don't have any Zelda games that I can stream. The only Zelda game I own is Ocarina of Time for the 3DS, and I do not have the capability of streaming that, and I don't want to try emulating and streaming. I feel like that's probably not going to work out as I would hope it would. So I am playing Sable because I looked up a list of games that are like Zelda but aren't Zelda, and Sable is the one that I had. And I know pretty much nothing about this game. I know I have heard good things about it in the past, but I have not personally seen much about it. It seems nice, looks nice. I mean, this title screen area is a little minimalist, but I'm looking forward to giving it a try and seeing how it goes. As always, if you can let me know how the audio levels are for myself and for the game, at the moment, the game's not. It's really low, if any noise. So, once I get started, you can let me know on that front, and I will look into fixing any issues that come up. My current plan is to stream for a couple hours, but I do have flexibility if things are looking like I want to continue. And that's the same for just the game in general. This might
Might
become
become
a
a
regular
regular thing
thing if today goes well. And
and
it
it is
is just
just
me,
me,
just
just
Rio,
Rio,
helping
helping
out.
out.
Hi.
Hi, hi,
If you,
Hugh.
there
There
is
is
a
a
possibility
possibility
of
of
my
my
cat
cat
joining
joining
in
in
the
the
co-commentating.
co-commentating.
She's
She's
currently
currently
in
in
my
my
lap,
lap,
but
but
she's
she's
being
being
quiet
quiet
at
at
the
the
moment.
moment.
But
But
I
I think
think it's
it's time
time to
to
get
get
started
started
here.
here.
New
New game
game select
select
file.
file.
Looks
Looks
like
like
there
there
are
are
three
three
save
save
files
files
here.
here.
And
And
let's
let's
start
start
a
a
new
new
game.
game.
Oh,
Oh,
echoing.
echoing.
Double
Double
audio.
audio.
Okay,
Okay,
let's
let's
take
take
a
a
look
look
and
and
figure
figure
out
out
what's
what's
going
going
on
on
there.
there. How's this now, Golden? Also, welcome. Thanks for the comment. Thanks for coming by. Oh, this looks pretty. We got sand coming down. We got a skull, you know, and a beetle. Sounds great now. Yeah, for some reason there was a second mic source that I didn't usually have in the setup, but I guess because I'm doing the main one without the guests, it was different. And presumably, this is the player character, and that is a face. Is it going to talk to me? Hello? I like the lighting. I just generally like the look of the game. Quest started the ceremony. Well, definitely can move around. Did that. Any other instructions here? Do I have to move all the way up? Oh. Okay, I guess I can climb. And I'm assuming, yeah, that square there is my stamina, I guess. And I've made it here. I have climbed the face. Yeah, this is Breath of the Wild. This is Zelda week, so we're falling. Okay, I'm alive. We're good. Anything else? There's a loose brick thing here. Not sure what else to do. Am I supposed to leave now? Let's take a look at what's in this room. Alright. So standing on that opens that, but I'm going to assume that when I step off this... Oh, nope, it does stay open. Alright. No. Space to jump. That's what I figured. I mean, these designs are intricate, but I'm not sure they're displaying as well as would be best for y'all to see just how intricate and detailed all of the designs are. But I'm gonna move towards a wall to begin climbing. Keep an eye on your stamina. Well, we already know about that. We already climbed the face. We are old hands at this kind of stuff. Yeah, a true Zelda-like. Hello, Kelly. Welcome. But, you know, sometimes it's good to have a ladder to climb with. Ooh. See to crouch. I'm pretty sure I phased through that before I even crouched, but, you know. Ooh, bird. Bird. Where? Going. So how's the game audio for y'all? It's fine on my end, but I know it's not always the same for those on the watcher side of things. Can I just jump down from here? We're gonna try it. Yeah, I'm concerned about fall damage, but it doesn't seem to be relevant at the moment. Alright, I'm gonna test something out here. Yep, we do have a sprint. Nope, couldn't reach that. And I don't think I have the stamina to get to the top. Oh, I do. Yep. So I got a desert environment here, it looks like. What's that out in the distance? Looks like a ruin with some runes on it. But I imagine we're supposed to go to the tower first, so... that is what I shall do. If this is truly a Zelda-like, where is my parachute? Such a ripoff. See, and I already figured out the sprint part. And what happens when I deplete the stamina gauge? No, I just slow down. Ibex camp. I see a distinct lack of ibexes in this area. I see a distinct lack of life that is not plants in this area. And even those are on the few side. Oh, here we go. There's a person. Yeah, I like the look as well. It's... I don't really know exactly how to describe it. I can feel Jadi smiling behind her mask, just as I know she can feel the teeth-bearing little grimace behind mine. I'm nervous and she's softly, sweetly amused. In her eyes, I probably have very little to worry about. You know you have nothing to worry about, don't you, Sable? And yet, I know, I'm not worried. And yet, I shrug, but any attempts to act casual are fruitless. The movement is jerky, and I don't think I've ever been more aware of my little shoulders. She laughs. I mean it. But I do know who you, how you are. You're going to be nervous until you've started, and then you'll act like you've been doing it your whole life. Remember the first time you rode a bike? Oh, we have bikes in this. Yeah, I don't have the best history with bikes personally. That's how I broke my arm. You wouldn't even let me put you on the seat, you were so afraid. Your hands were like little claws gripping onto me. I feel the memory in my fingers. But then I promised you it was going to be all right. I told you how much I had loved riding my bike as a young woman and how wonderful the wind felt through fabric. Suddenly, there you were. You sat down, you leaned forward and put those little grasping claws on the handles, and you were off. And I remember thinking, just watching you tear over the sand. Look at her. She can do whatever she wants. Jaddy reaches out and places a hand on the edge of my mask. And you can, Sable. I take a breath. I don't know where to start. Jaddy's story warms me, but I feel too overwhelmed to let it settle. I tell her with a sigh that I don't know where to begin. She chuckles. Well, I can help with that. You'll need to talk to Hillel and Driss. Driss should already have made the arrangements for your bike, and Hillel will share something. Well, let's say as useful as it is fun. I think I might suspect what Jaddy's saying, but I stay quiet. After that, I suppose we'll see you off. I'll be back soon. Sable, don't go planning your return before you've even left. Take all the time you need. It's a big decision you're making out there. I tell her that's why I'm so eager to make it. To choose well and quickly so that I don't go too far down the wrong path. Whatever you decide, you do so with my blessing. So don't try using me as an excuse to come home early, eh? She knows me. Now go speak with Hillel. I'll be there to see you off. And speak to Driss as well. I've told him to arrange your bike with Sizzo, but you know how he is. I have something to give you, a compass to help you on your journey. It's the same one I used on my gliding, an artifact, you might say. I take the device in my palm. It fits naturally there, perfectly weighted and crafted. Each component slides together with incredible, satisfying precision. Thank you. So I've got a compass. Ooh, that's how the compass works. Well. Fun. Ah, what's this over here? We got some jars and all that. And I know I was supposed to go and talk to people, but let's talk to this person that I was told to talk to. As she looks out across the landscape, Zeki's shoulders sag a little. I wonder what she's thinking about. Well, that just, she seems to be whistling for something, so I feel like that's what she's thinking about. Something on your mind? Zeki's voice is weakly incredulous.
I don't know how she's done it. That's Ilaria over there.
Oh, hi. There's a person up there. Hello, Ilaria. Maybe I should go and join you. I follow her gaze to a little speck in the distance, which I now understand is her daughter, Ilaria. Do you want me to get her back? Zeki shakes her head. No, she's fine, and I'll get her. I'm just... She shrugs. Parenting. I suppose I'll know more about that when I'm older. Sure I will. Sure I will. Okay. Let's go climb the tower.
Stairs, stairs, stairs.
By the way, the cat is sitting next to my chair just meowing at me through all of this. We got 20-somethings from that. Is it money? It's probably money. And you have what looks like a telescope, maybe? Don't go too close, I'm trying to figure out what this person had. No, I just gotta ask.
Sizo looks busy. I should leave her to it.
Should I? Should I, though? Okay, the thing in the left hand is a compass, but what's the one in the right? Eh, I'll figure it out.
Ah, so fall damage not really looking like much of a thing here. That's good. Yeah, so Hillel was over here and Driss is the one down, right? Or did I get that reversed? I guess I'll find out. As I approach Hillel, I got it right. They give an enthusiastic wave. I've always appreciated Hillel's verve and vigor. And on a day like this, I'm ready to match it, with a touch of nerves for balance. Sable, take this! Hillel hands me a small round stone. As it nestles into my palm, I feel a warmth not borrowed from Hillel's hands, but emanating from within. I run my thumb over it and find it softly electric, like static on cloth. What is this? I try to sound less confused than I am, but ask Hillel what this is. Oh, Sable, you can't leave without it. What I've just given you is a gliding stone. What do you feel? I tell Hillel that I feel electricity. Then you're doing it right. What you feel in that stone is openness. I look at the stone. It seems quite closed. Gliding stones are vessels for the perpetual. They suck up its power like little sponges and hold it there for you to channel. Right now it's empty, or dormant, and waiting for you to fill it up. I ask how I can do this. Take it to the temple ruins at the edge of the canyon. You'll be able to activate it there. Hillel claps their hands twice and bobs a little. I appreciate their good mood at a time like this. Come back to me once that's done. I want to hear all about it. As I'm about to leave, Hillel stops me. Oh, you haven't gotten your bike yet, have you? It's a bit of a trek to the temple, so go see Driss. He was meant to get that ready for you, yes? I remember Jadi's words now and tell Hillel I'll go and see Driss. Let's view this quest log. The ceremony and the whispering stones. Activate the gliding stone at the altar. And let's see. This is the map, so I'm over here. Controls and stuff. Inventory. Bike part, badges, fishing! Isn't a video game without some nice fishing. Ah. Off to Driss we go! Whee! Boom. You've got like a beetle look about you there. I mean, we've all got unique looks, but you are very much like a beetle. Though I've told myself not to be too eager, it's all I can do not to race up to Driss. Driss is the camp manager. He's been difficult to get a hold of lately, but now I strongly suspect that he's been working on my bike in secret. Perhaps it's extra beautiful, or has some custom feature. What will its name be, I wonder? How fast will it go? Will my legs feel sore, or will I get used to that? Driss turns with a bit of a start. Sable! Hello! I was told you have something special for me. I tell Driss that I was told he had something for me. Something special? I nod very meaningfully, but he doesn't seem to get the hint. I make a leading gesture, slowly, trying to be perfectly cool and confidential. But I can't do it. I'm too keen and the words spill out. I ask Driss if he might, sort of, possibly, maybe have a bike for me. Your bike! He yells it like it's an idea he's just had. Your bike! Yes! Of course, right. Yes, your bike. That I was meant to. That I prepared for you, because today is your... Did you forget? In abject horror, I gently ask if he may have forgotten. What? What? I would never. It's obviously I have your bike. By which I mean I arranged it for you in a... Well, it's sort of a tutorial for you. Not exactly, but that's because this is part of your gliding. You see, Sable, before one can own their own bike, they must prove that they can ride a bike by taking a test ride on a different bike. I think about it and find I've never heard of that part of the gliding, but Driss does seem earnest. Sort of.
Yes, they are not subtle in the tutorial part.
So instead of worrying about your bike, I'd like you to try this bike as a test.
Driss gestures to the sand cutter at his side, and it's quite old and a little shabby. A tester, if ever I've seen one. I'll give it a go.
Really? I mean, yes, good. Be gentle, though. This sand cutter's older than Jadi. You treat her with respect. Now, ride the bike through the ring and back.
Oh, so that's what that thing was I saw in the distance.
And here's some advice for you, my young glider. Don't fall off.
When you're not riding it, your hover bike will appear as a blue icon on your something that I did not see in time. Alright. Do-do-do. There. So there's some rocks in the way, so I guess I gotta go around this way. And we're through the ring. And let's get back. Woo. Yeah, strafing works. And stop! Graceful. It's a good thing Driss was looking in the other direction. No, don't stop. Don't stop. Stop. Has it stopped? No, gravity is still happening. He's probably not gonna notice. I return to Driss, who somehow manages to seem caught off guard despite knowing I was coming.
Sable! Congratulations! How was your first pre-glide ride?
Any strange rattles, unexplained hissing, small fires?
What do you mean, fires? Surely you'd notice if you were on fire, even a little bit.
Yes, absolutely.
Well, obviously it didn't happen, so I think we're fine.
Driss, is this bike dangerous?
Well,
he doesn't finish. Have you already been by Hillel?
Oh, right.
I'd nearly forgotten about Hillel and thanked Driss for the reminder, before at least nudging him a little about the bike. I ask him if I'll still be getting one.
Well, you're getting the use of this sand cutter. That's something, eh? You can borrow it to run your little errands.
My little errands.
And Hillel's got something to show you too. Help you out with more of that mobility you're after.
With my confidence in this exercise only lightly tarnished, I thank Driss very much for his help and his bike, and I depart for Hillel.
I saw Hillel. Was there more that I needed?
Alright, guess I gotta check. Hillel, did you forget to give me something? Is there something else going on? Yeah, alright.
What?
I was trying to climb the other thing. I guess that was too much to ask. Ooh, can I jump from... No, I can't jump from one wall to the other. At least not yet. See, this is important. I am learning my limits. And that limit is there. Okay, we're just gonna go around. Oh, hello. I found you. How is it that Saima manages to contain so much chaos and verve in so small a form? Even now, there is something troublesome being dreamed up behind that mask. I know it.
I didn't even talk to Saima, really.
Oh, what's this? Ooh. Ibex red dye. The dye bottle for the colors of the Ibexy red bike. Ibexy.
See, usually when you have those dots, you're supposed to be talking.
But no. You don't want to talk. Well, we're back to where I started, so. What's the best way to go around? We do seem to have... I guess you're our farmer? Umar is a man of few words, and he's nothing if not consistent. Haying is a difficult thing. I also would not recommend that fire next to this wooden fence. This feels like a very poor idea. Next to the fence, next to the hay, next to the bushes. How is this area not entirely in flames? I'm gonna throw. That was a good throw. Was there any point to that? No, but it was a good throw. Ooh, we have another bucket. We're gonna throw that one too. That's not exactly the direction I was going for. Fire safety is important, and I don't think these people really understand that. Alright. Hillel, we're back! What did you fail to give us the first time? Head over to the temple, Sable. I promise it'll be worth the trip. But, fine. I'll go over to the temple. And I guess I'll use the sand cutter to get there. So... the temple was over this way, based on what... I was told. So, let's go! Ooh, bounce, bounce, bounce.
I'm not sure this is the safest vehicle we could take. Maybe I should be walking.
Wait, is that a boat? Let's check this out. We got a boat. I will say that it's very good at righting itself when I, tip it upside down. Yep. Haha, this is why we check the boats. I guess there's gotta be something going on there. Staring in this direction, so I'm assuming the temple is that thing over there, because it's definitely not the rock. Alright, we're also going to test what happens when I ram straight into the rock here. That's some good force absorption. Alright. Do I have to climb up to get to that? I guess we're gonna find out. Go, Sable, go. Also, I wasn't sure if Sable was going to be the name of the character, but I guess I have found out. Don't know what that is, but I don't know. We got another wall to climb up. Yeah, I wasn't sure how Zelda-like this was going to be, but it is definitely Zelda-like. And I say that as someone who doesn't really play Zelda, but it's pretty evident. Ooh, what's this? You are sparkly, and I must have you. It is a chum egg? Offered up by chums when planting themselves into the ground, perfectly smooth and hard as a rock, these eggs seem to float with how light they are. They are hard as a rock, but floating... Okay. There must be a good place to deliver these.
Well, I'm not sure yet, but I'll find out at some point. Possibly, maybe.
Where Plankton gets his chum from. You see, SpongeBob references are generally going to be lost on me. I never really watched the show. It was specifically banned in my house because my family found it annoying, or at least my parents did. Can't say me and my siblings could because we did. Why? Why? This. I'm concerned about the architecture in the area now. Maybe we shouldn't be exploring these areas. Everything they're sending us on is dangerous. And I know we take no fall damage, but that's still not an excuse for being reckless. And in we go, and I very much hope... Okay. Cutscene time. So this is definitely the temple. This is the right spot. We got a cutscene. The stone thrums like the beat of a heart as I approach the altar. Am I afraid, exhilarated, or maybe it feels right? Let's go with it feels right. I am ready for Rohana to know me. I am ready to know myself. I feel her curiosity in this sacred place. I know I am in her sight. And I have an object that looks like a hand warmer, but is now floating out of my hand. Ooh, pretty colors. Now I'm getting enveloped by this. Are we good here? What just happened? Did I gain powers? See, it looks like there was a celebration here with the things going around. And now we're taking the elevator up to... Oh. I was kind of expecting to go a little higher. Got my thing back. And I guess it's time to go show Hillel the activated lighting stone. Ah, it's there. I was kind of expecting there was a chest. Oh, yeah. If you're gonna leave just a brick lying around like this, at least let me pick it up and throw it, like the buckets, or push it off like it's an object in Stray. Gotta make sure. There's no things around that I could get money from. Nope. Alright. Alright, this might be a little bit of a challenge. There you go. Gliding. Ah, so that's what the power gave me. See, now we're getting there. Favorite video game antagonist. Huh. You see, I think a lot more about the protagonists that I like. Antagonists generally don't... They don't resonate as much with me. So, I'm gonna have to think on that. I don't think I have one off the top of my head. Let's see. good antagonist, one that I really like. I mean, I think it's different for different types of games as well. Like, it's always good to have a really outright evil antagonist. Oh, I think I've got one. Maybe not my favorite all time, but kind of the first one I thought of that I think is just a really well-developed one. And I was thinking about this game earlier, and that would be Chester Stoddart from East the Oath and Fel'Ghana, who, I mean, is an antagonist, but has understandable reasons, and the performance by the actor that I can't remember the name, absolutely fantastic. There are plenty of other antagonists, but I think Chester is a really solid one. So does gliding? No, gliding doesn't take up stamina, so I can get up to here. Yes. And that gets me on top of this bridge. Ah. See, one of the few things I did know about Sable was that you got, like, the bike to move around in with, so I wasn't sure how traversal was going to work outside of that, but seems fun so far. Got some good skills to move around in, and let's go on back through this. Is it just because it's in the day now, and that's why things are a little more vibrant color-wise? I'm going to assume that is the case. Alright, now, the question is, where did I leave the bike? I think it was in this direction. Ooh, that effect on the bushes, the wind housing that is aggressive. There we go. I knew what I was doing. I knew where it was. Alright. I'll just return, but I'm gonna note that over there, because that's probably, if I'm free to do what I want after this, then I might just go there. Woo! That's some air! Ho ho! Let's see. Ooh, can I go up off that? Yeah. Alright, so that is the fun part of this bike, is getting that air. And I specifically need to go to Hillal, so I'll stop over here and then climb up this spot, which probably should have done before when I was trying to get up there. But, you know, we all gotta find our own ways to things. Is this just... Ooh, I can interact. Locking in. Ooh, a post box. Hello, Sable. Unread messages. 0. Have a good day. Okay. No one wants to message me. Hi, hello. I did the thing. It's active. Now what? When I return to Hillal, it's clear they know what I've just experienced. They're excited on my behalf, in a way that makes me miss them before I've even left. Isn't it incredible? How does it feel? Safe, like a warm hug. I tell Hillal that I feel almost embraced by the perpetual, warm and safe in my own little bubble. They swoon. Oh, that's such a nice way of describing it. Hillal's mood doesn't darken, but the sigh they let out holds a bit of sorrow. You're very lucky, you know. I miss it so much, that feeling, just floating on the breeze. But I suppose it's best that it fades with age, hmm?
or else I might never have come back from my gliding. I'd just be out there heaving myself into chasms. See? See, Hillel and I are on the same page. That's definitely going to happen. I'll heave myself into chasms for you. I tell Hillel I'll throw myself into 1,000 chasms on their behalf, and they giggle. That's what I like to hear. I know people manage to keep it up, but I don't know that I've got the time to practice as much as they do. It takes a really serious focus. Hillel laughs, even if there's a bit of regret in it. And I certainly haven't got that. Still, I suppose the gliding wouldn't mean much if it were all gains and no loss, hmm? I think about that, but decide that there is already too much loss on my mind to consider it much further. I am saying goodbye to my clan, my family, my home, my childhood. To lose the perpetual is a sacrifice for another time. You're going to love it out there, Sable. Even when you don't. My advice? Try to have fun. There's a lot to be said about ritual and independence and all of that out there, but the world's an easier place if you put joy first. I thank Hillel for their advice and for their help, and tell them I'll miss them. It'll be over before you know it. A warning and a reassurance all in one. I say goodbye to Hillel. Before I go, Hillel gestures towards the tower. It seems Saizo wishes to see me before I leave the clan. Yeah, now you wanna see me, when before you just ignored me. Heckin' rude. Alright, let's go. Ooh, there is a thing over there. Maybe I'll do that first, and then I'll go deal with Saizo. Cover the stamina. We shall get to the top here. Oh, there's two people up here. Hello. What are you two up to? I approach the cartographer. Ooh, cartographer. Yep, I can see. You got the map in hand. Ah, greetings, child. I saw you looking longingly at my great balloon. Quite a piece of work, isn't she? Balloon? I'm going to assume it's up there that I can't see at the moment because I'm too focused on you. Longingly? I clarified that I was looking curiously, and that balloons aren't exactly my ideal vessel. The newcomer shrugs. Fair enough. I suppose when you can ensconce yourself in a peaceful little bubble and float down from the sky, the balloon loses some of its charm. I only just got that ability, so I'm curious if this dialogue is different if you hadn't gotten the ability yet. But I'll accept your curiosity. I give the balloon an approving nod so that he doesn't feel too bad. Well, good to meet you. And, oh, I should introduce myself. I'm Jordan. I tell him. I'm Sable. Suppose if you've come all this way to see me, it's probably a map you're after, eh, Sable? I would love a map. I tell the cartographer I'd love a map. Of course you would. That'll be 50 cuts. To my ears, it's a fair price for a map, but too expensive for my pre-gliding glider with empty pockets. I tell Jordan, I'll be back. I'll need to ask Jadi for some money. Farewell, child. Purveyor and surveyor. Alright, let's take a look. Oh, yeah. There's a balloon. Hi. The balloon was more fun than the person in it.
Oof. Don't hide how you feel, Ilaria.
What? I can't climb that?
Yeah. Fine. I shall glide.
Jadi. I need the money. I tell Jadi that the cartographer wants 50 cuts for a map of the Ewer. I try to hedge the way I speak about this, as I'm not entirely sure whether that's too much, not enough, or precisely its value. She tells me not to worry. Here's some money to get you going on your journey. Use it mostly wisely.
Use it mostly wisely. See, that's a proper parental figure. You know they're not actually going to use it completely wisely. So, mostly. And then a little unwisely when the mood strikes. It's good to know the value of money, but you never want to be ruled by it. I thank Jaddy effusively and head out on my way. Ah. I have the money now. Give me the map. You could also just give me the balloon. Will you give me that for 200 cuts? Greetings, child. Perfect. Let's trade then. Okay, select that, confirm, and we have a map. I thank Jordan for the Ewer map and all its vast possibilities. Something about this makes it feel more real. Good luck on your gliding, Sable. I still remember mine. I ask how it was. Short. I knew since I was a boy that cartography was for me, but I spent a little extra time out there just to enjoy the world. Speaking of, keep an eye on the skies, eh? Plenty of my colleagues out there, and they'll have more maps to sell you, from Hakoa to the Sodic Waste. I thank Jordan for the tip and say goodbye. Farewell, child. Unlocked a piece of the map. You navigate to the map screen in the pause menu. Once you've visited a place, you can fast travel to that location using the map screen. Your hover bike will also travel with you. Very convenient. Whoop, I did not mean to talk to you. Let's take a look at the map. Ah, so this is what we have. I can add markers. Whoop, did not mean to add that as a marker. Clear all markers. So that's the Ibex camp. So, over here? Is this the temple? No, the temple's... Yeah, the temple's here. So, I'll add a marker there. That's the thing that I was looking at before. Ah. Alright, I guess we kept you waiting long enough, Saizo. Come on. Blah, 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 blah. Mm-hmm. Up the stairs we go. So I wonder how long it takes to go through a day-night cycle in Sable. Seems to be going at a decent pace. Saizo is an outclanner to the Ibexi, but I've known her for nearly as long as I can recall, and think of her more as a kind of distant relation than any sort of outsider. Machinists, I'm told, are given their posts, and by their training and their code, must go to where they are needed, but Saizo has been among us so long that it's easy to forget it's an assignment first and foremost. As far as any of us are concerned, she's one of us. I think there is a perception among the other clans that the Ibexi are quite insular, or that our designation of Ibexi versus Outclanners suggests some nervous othering of those who are unlike us. But in practice, such things are more the result of our nomadic nature. We seek to know who we will travel with, who will travel with us, and who we must leave behind. But all are welcome to join. And I'm always pleased that Saizo did. Sable, how do you do, clan child? I can only think of one thing. I think there's a little bit of a focus for Sable. Just getting a hint of it. Excited for my bike. Saizo has a throaty quality to her voice, and it rumbles through her mask when she laughs. She's quite a serious person most days, and I am always torn between pride and alarm when I manage to make her chuckle. Yes, Jaddy told me how excited you were. Saizo sniffs.
She also told me Driss would be coming along to get your bike all together, but I think he may have... I knew it. What? I hadn't meant to say that out loud, so I tell her I was just clearing my throat. I don't begrudge Driss his forgetfulness. Were I tasked with so many odds and ends, I might be just scattered. And besides, this will be good for you. I want you to scavenge the hover bike parts yourself. I mean, technically Driss should do it, but it does sound like an adventure and getting to make my own hover bike. No, you're not going to make your hover bike. You are going to build your own hover bike. Ooh, that's a good hook for the opening part of the game. Collecting parts to make your own hover bike. Mm-hmm. Of course. To make suggests you are creating something, but your bike already exists. They simply haven't taken form yet. Here, take this. I saw Sam hands me something. That was the thing she was holding earlier, the navigator. This is a navigator. You can use it to mark waypoints on your compass. It should be useful in finding the old parts. I asked Saizo where I might start looking. Our bikes are reborn in the ruined ships, in fragments spread apart. A good start would be the ship down there near the camp. We'll find another up on that great rock near the other side of the canyon. And another behind the old dam on the hill. Use your navigator to mark that down if you need. You'll need to gather a control panel, a power supply, and a calibrator. Do most gliders make their own bikes? Only the lucky ones. I tell Saizo I'll see her soon and head off in search of the components. Together, we will create something new out of the old. Ah, so, if I hit the navigator... Ooh. Mark interesting landmarks. Ah. Well, that's the only thing that is currently marked. Oh, so there's one that's marked and one that's not. So we'll start over at the ship. There. Alright, off we go. Wah. Yeah, it looks like there'd be some parts in here. I like how I get catapulted slightly forward. Don't you go anywhere. I'm watching you. That I get catapulted forward a little bit when I stop. Like I'm jumping off the bike instead of properly braking and doing stuff. Ooh. So that's there. There's nothing of use to be found in the ship, but I notice a blinking light flashing on the dashboard of the cockpit. Alright. Shall we push the button? Of course we shall. A voice crackles from the machinery in front of me. It sounds like a recording. It's barely audible. Stop messing about with those buttons, you absolute idiot! Sorry, Revan. Concentrate. I don't think I have to remind you how much work it was to get this far. We're almost there! Alright, let's see if what that old machinist told us holds up. If not, there'll be hell to pay. I hear the sounds of mechanical adjustments being made. Three clicks. Buttons being pressed, perhaps? Okay, when I push this orange thing, pull that lever hard. Yes, Roman. The sound of a click and a loud grunt before a snapping sound. Oh, on Rohanna's mask! Not that hard! You've torn it out! Suddenly, the speakers are filled with static and a low rumble that gradually increases in pitch. And then the sounds of someone cheering. It worked! We're flying! More cheering. Is that the sound of someone dancing? Okay, let's focus. This thing is moving fast. We need to slow it down a bit. How do we do that, Brahmin? Let me check the mechanist's notes. A long pause. The rumbling static sound that started playing when the ship took off is still increasing in pitch.
Ramen?
That lever, Toma! The one you just ripped out! We're going too fast! We're going to crash! We need to try to... The recording cuts off there.
Okay, we're just gonna imagine that they were all fine and no one died at all. It's all good. I'm not looting the ship at all.
Anything around? They mentioned an orange thing, an orange lever pulled out. Oh. Oh, hello. Are you looking for a calibrator?
I am looking for a calibrator, Saima. Now you're ready to talk to me.
I am immediately on guard. Saima has always been a mischief maker and taken tremendous pleasure in tormenting me. In theory, I am older, more experienced, and should be more than able to withstand it. In practice...
You won't find it here. I've hidden it. You'll never find it. Never, never.
She never fails to get to me. May I please have it? I decide to be gentle and ask her, may I please have it?
May I please have it?
She mimics me terribly, all high and screechy. Despite my best efforts, I seethe. Seethe.
Oh well, too bad. Maybe you'll find it on your own.
But I don't think so. Saima laughs off my irritation, but I'm not going to give her the satisfaction. I cross my arms and try to effect a change.
I'll give you the calibrator.
I put out my hand, proud of myself for standing tall before Saima.
If you give me some beetles.
That's a fair trade, isn't it? Something you want for something I want. I try to decide if it's more mature to push her over and steal the calibrator or to acquiesce. But then I simply stifle a sigh and shake her little hand. Perhaps some of the adults in the camp know where I can find some. Beetles. We shall get the beetles. And apparently it was better when Simon was not talking to me. Well, fine. What did I even hit off of there? Whee! Yeah, didn't get it at the right angle to get the good jump. Ooh, what's this side? I didn't actually see this before. What is this here? I wonder if it's possible for me to find the calibrator without Saima's help. Like, and I'm probably not going to do it. I'll go the beetle route. But if I manage to go to the location wherever she's hidden it and then search there, would I then be able to completely bypass the beetle part of this? I'm curious, but I don't think that's the route that I'm going to go because I don't feel like searching the entire desert. Does it have a hint in... here, ask around the camp. Okay, so just anyone in the camp. Jaida, could ask about catching beetles. There's a nest of beetles just east of here. You can't just walk up to one and catch it, though. There's some seeds growing on the rocks around the nest. Drop a seed on the floor, and the beetle will start eating it. Then you could sneak up and grab it. That's big glider to you. You're right, you are. Sable, noted adult, and big glider. I'll keep it in mind. So I need 3 beetles, and they said east. Let's see. How do I get out the compass again? So north is that way, so east is this way. Okay. failed to see this one before. Got more money. Set east of here, so we're gonna keep going. Probably easier if I had the bike, but you know. Sometimes it's best to do things on your own two feet. I do like the music there. This is a nice, soothing track. Alright. It is possible that the beetle's nest is up on the hill, in which case, I'm gonna need to do some climbing. And I want to start off small and get bigger. And this looks like something I can climb over here. Yeah, actually, I could probably climb right here. And then looks like there's a tunnel. Of some sort. There is a bird. Just continue on upwards. Yeah, those are beetles. Hello, beetle friends. Now, where to get the seeds? I understand. Can I just... Okay, so they're gonna bury themselves if I approach the normal way, but I need... Yep. Well, you're not a seed, you're another chumbag. These look like plants. Do you have seeds? You do not appear to have seeds. Yeah, so I definitely have... Maybe these plants are them? Are you my seed? Nope. This is going great. Going great. I don't know exactly what seeds I'm supposed to get and where they are, but I mean, I feel like it has to be these ones. There we go. So I knocked off seed. But you can still see me, so I'll just leave that there and sneak up and get. Ha! Got them both. Ooh, and I still have the seed. That is a giant seed, by the way. Huh? What? A noise happened. Ha! I got the beetles, and that's all three, right? Let's check. Yep, three. I was thinking about maybe getting one for later. Ooh, more money. Getting another beetle for later, but I'll just take this along. And the map. Yeah, so I'm over here. Ooh, so I can just fast travel to the camp.
I don't think that was it, Golden, because I believe when I was starting up the stream, I saw that Emmy had followed 16 hours ago. I think it may have been an achievement sound for me, but it didn't come up properly. Are those? There's something red in the distance there. It's definitely got that exploration itch that you get just by seeing things on the horizon. The question is it going to pay off? Alright. I did my deal. Give me the calibrator. I feel embarrassingly vindicated as I hand Syma the beetles, but rather than gloat, she hands me the calibrator and begins to cry. What have I done? You're leaving. You're leaving and you'll never come back. Let her cry it out. She blows her nose and then wipes her hand on her tunic. Yara never came back after the last gliding. Aren't you sad? You were her friend. I miss her too. There's been a letter here and there, but it is always to us rather than to me. I'm not bitter, but I hope not to be like that. Please don't go. I tell Simon not to worry, that I will be back sooner than she knows, and I'm sure she pouts behind the mask. And I add that I am not back sooner than she knows. Then she will be ready for her gliding by then, and she can come bother me herself. Promise? I say yes. Good. Then I suppose I can come see you off. I thank her and say goodbye for now. The epic achievement sound. I guess so. I think I've played another... I think a couple other games on Epic, but don't remember that being a sound on there. But yeah, this is one of the first games that I played on Epic rather than Steam. So it is quite possible that the previous ones that I got, I either didn't get achievements or there weren't achievements for me to get. Alright, where did I left off the bike. I thought I left it off the bike around here. Where is it? Oh, they parked it over on the other side. Yep, there we go. So, I guess next we can go check out the dam, since that appears to be the next closest thing. We do have our friend the ring up the hill. Oh, and there's a chum. Come here, chum. I got ya. Chumig. And the dam over here. Looks like that one might be a little bit of a challenge to climb. I wonder if I'm gonna get stamina upgrades like in Breath of the Wild. Oh, but I don't need to because there's an open part of the dam right there. Sure hope there doesn't get any water in here. That might go poorly for me. And we got a ladder as well. Nothing else.
it's the Iambix Village. There's something over to, so if that's east, this is west, that would be the south. Yep, bird. Bye, bird. Bye-bye, birdie. Oh, did not expect to bounce off like that. Oh, 20 cuts. Very nice. Controls. We hit the thing, and now let's glide over and make our way through. I forgot which thing was supposed to be over here, but I'm going to assume that it's over in this wreck. I'll start with you. Yep. And pretty evident that I'm supposed to put it there. Like-colored things go with like-colored things. As in, the colors of the lights are the same. It's a vent. In proper trails fashion, I must go through it, right? No? Okay. Alright, I don't really see anything that I'm supposed to be doing here. Nothing's really standing out to me. Can I? Take that? No, I cannot take that off. Yeah, I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing there, so let's go around to another spot. Stamina before I climb this thing. Ha! Stayed on it long enough to get there anyways. Okay. Does being on the roof actually do anything for me? It doesn't appear to. Must be something I was missing in there. So I don't see another way in. Yeah, that really seems to be the only way in. And if I remove that, yeah, it closes the door. Is there some place I can crouch and get through? Is that it? I haven't really used the crouch mechanic at all. I'm still not really seeing anything. Get into that spot.
That might just be... a coincidence. Well, guess I gotta look somewhere else. Maybe there's another object around that I haven't seen that will help. Say that. I don't think there's a gap in there, but you never know. We can check out this pipe situation. Nope, no way through there. Yeah, I don't think that's it. I'm gonna go with being stumped on that one. May have to go and check out the other location and see if there's something there. Looks like there's a couple figures up on that spot. Not sure I've got enough stamina to get up there though, even with stuff nearby to climb, start from. But we shall try anyways. So there's a ship. Alright, so those black figures were birds. Never mind, that's not helpful. Yeah, well. Another chum egg. Maybe at some point I'll figure out what these are actually for. Spot. Let's go check that out. Looks like a little shrine to something. And we stole the money from the shrine. Am I a bad person? Probably. Look, I am a person now. I am the shrine. Hmm.
Alright, well, in the interest of being able to travel to places, I will. So that's the one over there. Yeah, if I mouse over. Okay, that only that gives the actual name of it. But I can. I will remove that and. What? I'm just trying to travel to this spot. How do I? I guess maybe I can only travel. See, when I click on that, I can travel there, but these other spots, they have the wing that would make me think that you can fast travel to them. But it does not appear to be happening, and I do not know why. Yeah, travel to the camp. We're back. And where's my bike? There it is. Ah. So. This time. I just want to check the markers, but I guess that's not happening right now. I should check, yeah, find a control panel, find a power supply. Didn't seem to mean like there's any spot in there, so now let's take off and check. Yeah, it's up there is supposed to be a spot with one of the things. One of control panel or power supply. And I hope it's a little more evident on how to get it than the last spot that I checked. That's another big bounce. Here just because I can. And stop. That is some impressive climbing. That looks like a very flat surface to me. And I can barely climb on things that actually have handholds for me. This time, I might not get to the thing that I'm going for. Yeah, didn't quite get there. Just continue on this way and then move over once the time comes. Oop. What's this spot? Oh. An alternate route for climbing up, I guess. I'm not gonna have enough energy to get up there. Yeah. Not enough stamina. So, let's Those are all too far away for that to actually be helpful to my climbing efforts. I guess this is the route that I have to take. I feel like I don't normally have to think about the climbing routes that I go in games. Good ways up. Still got some stuff to go. And stairs! Oh, look at that! Oh, that makes things a lot easier. And then we got this over here. Ooh-lee-yo. Ah. This is a regular thing. Oh, is it really this? Gonna be this easy? There we go. There's the power supply. That was so much easier. What was the other stuff? Let me just crouch and get under. Yeah, that was so much easier than whatever the other thing is supposed to be sending me towards. Alright, the bike's gonna be down this way. Yep. Ooh, can I land right on it? Okay, so there is a limit on the height stuff. So, let me get off and then I can look properly at. So as a task for me, that's what I'm currently doing. Find a control panel. Yeah, I didn't see anything that looked like a control panel over there. Yeah, I was definitely happy to see those stairs. The game has not given me enough tools for making climbing easier for me not to be excited for stairs. I'm generally excited for stairs as well. I'm one of those people that will take the stairs instead of the elevator. Right, let's go off this small rock. Woo! Whoa, okay, that was a rougher go than I thought it would. How many stories does it take? I don't know. I don't think it's that many. I don't think it's that dramatic. Mainly I'm thinking about where I work and where my office is in a building with three floors. And plenty of people, those who are coming up to meet with me or whatever, will take the elevator, even though it's only three floors. But I will always take the stairs. So, I don't know. Above five, I'm definitely going to start considering going up that... going by elevator. Four floors or more, yeah. That's fair. They did tell me to look up. Maybe there's something up that I didn't see. Up. Or anything down? Tell me what I'm supposed to be doing here. What am I supposed to do? Looking up, looking down. I'm looking all around and I am seeing a distinct lack of control panels. This is the location that I was told. Behind the dam, a ship. And I feel like there wouldn't... It's gotta be in here, because this is what I opened. I don't see anything around this side. And the thing I put in there isn't the... Oh! Wait, what? How? So that's out, while still... Oh, okay, that was just a glitch, I guess. Gonna take out frustration! Throw! That was not nearly as good of a throw as with the buckets. I can find this control panel thing. I may have to resort to Google, but I shall find it. Yeah, it's not even letting me climb up this side. It let me climb up the other side. This one, for some reason. There was a control panel in the dam. Can I just take that? That would work for a hover bike, right? Just finding myself a little stumped. I think the game has been mostly good about guiding me to the right spots so far. But this time, I'm feeling like I'm just left in the lurch. There's nothing that really indicates to me where I'm supposed to be going and what I'm supposed to be doing here. This is the only thing that I've been able to climb in any way. And it gets me absolutely nowhere. If I go back to Saizo, does she have a hint for me? Ships of old, find a control panel. Yes, that's my plan. I'm going to try and find the control panel, but we're going to do it. We're going to ask Saizo, see if she has anything for us, and if not, then, well, Google doesn't fail me. Saizo is waiting for the parts. Still need to find a control panel. Yep, so I'm in the right spot. Yep. Well, that was not helpful. So, Le Google, your time has come. So I found the calibrator, I found the power supply. Chat, my game might be bugged because they gave me the directions for this, and I've been there. I've been walking around in the right spot, but the object that is supposed to be there doesn't seem to be appearing. So I'll go back. And I'll go to the spot that at least this article is indicating it should be. Yeah, it's very odd. I mean, it makes sense to me that something is missing because that's how it feels looking around there. Like, if the thing isn't there, it has to be an error for the game, because I'm in the right spot, I have, and it not being there would be pretty much a screw you to the players, because that's where they told us to go. Ah, so it's open. And we'll check out. There it is. Alright, so. It tells me to put the battery in the receiver, which I did. Come in here. Turn left. And turn left again. The battery's supposed to be right here. Or not the battery, the control panel. It's supposed to be right here. So, we're going to ask Google again, but a different question. Control panel not appearing. Known issues. PL's not starting, bike flipping, well, I think the first thing that makes sense is for me to save and then exit to the title screen and see if that works. Let's exit and come back. But it's not my fault. This isn't my fault. It's the games.
And there we go. Oh, that's... There you go. We made it appear. Well, I feel vindicated by this, for I thought I was missing something so obvious that the game didn't even feel like it needed to prompt me, but no. Alright, Saizo, we're on our way back. And good to know that just exiting and coming back into the game fixed that issue. If it was something a little harder than that, then I'm not sure if I could have continued. And I know, again, my computer is not a spring chicken, but it's usually good on avoiding these things. But we have the materials. Does that mean that we can get a bike from Driss? I return to Saizo with the parts, and it says, it's as she waves me over that I feel a pang of sadness in my chest. When will I see her again once I'm gone? Well done, Sable. Yes, this is everything we need. Are you ready to assemble a bike of your own? Actually, there's some things I need to do first. Let's just check the quest thing. Okay, there's no other quest that I might need to do. Anytime they do that prompt, I'm always like, maybe there's something that I missed to do. I looked it up, Golden, and it didn't seem like anyone specifically had that bug, but there were other reported bugs of a similar nature, and the way they solved it was by exiting to the menu and going back in. So it's possible that I think it was the game. That is my thought on this. Saizo relaxes in the workshop. It isn't that she's particularly rigid or anxious ordinarily, but there's a certain calm beauty that one only truly appreciates when Saizo is in her element. I wonder if it's this way for all machinists. What you must understand, Sable, is that the components you acquired, they fit together. Not by chance, not by effort, but by nature. They belong to her. They have always belonged to her. All we are doing is assembling her from what she has already been. I nod and feel a soft buzzing in my ears. Among my clan, we believe that machines have names, held for ages like deep secrets, unheard by those unequipped to listen. We will find this one's name together. Assemble the machine! Okay, we're gonna assemble. So, if I take this part and put it here. Gliding bike booster. Alright. And you, my friend, are the gliding bike wings. And you are presumably the gliding bike steering. Gliding bike front. Let's put together. And press the button. And let's go. I kind of expected that to be a little more dramatic. Maybe some fanfare. Okay, well. It's fine. Listen. Saizo tilts her head a moment, leaning closer to Simon. Simon? All at once, I know this hover bike's name. Psymoon? No! Can I change that? I'm not sure I like that name. I say it in a whisper to let Saizo know. Psymoon. Psymoon. Well done, Sable. Yeah, what sort of a name is that? I ask Saizo what sort of name it is, and if it speaks to any particular clan or culture. If it does, then I do not know it. Perhaps you will find out on your journey. Saizo shrugs, mostly to herself. Or perhaps you won't, but I hardly think it matters. You are bonded all the same. I tell Psymoon that I am eager to know her better, and Saizo looks quite proudly at the both of us. You are ready, then, for the gliding. May all the gods turn their faces from you, Sable. Turn their faces from you? I guess that's a cultural thing in the game. We did start the game with a face staring at us. So I wonder if that's just part of the culture of this. An odd blessing, perhaps, but Saizo is prone to such things, and I can read in her tone that it was meant quite sweetly. You must learn to listen to Psymoon, to care for her. Seek out my fellow machinists on your travels, Sable. They will teach you the art of machine whispering.
Hey. Got a nice-looking engine there. This is now an ASMR stream just for machines. How do you like that?
Oh, and here, take this. Ooh, I got a badge. It's a machinist badge. You'll meet plenty of my ilk on your gliding. Show them your worth and they'll give you more badges. I thank Saizo twice for good measure and give a bow. I am ready. Golden was not ready for for that. Am I ready? It looks like my bike is still, you know, on this thing. Do I have people to talk to? Let's go check in with Driss. Tell him that I've built a bike and now he no longer has to forget to. Driss asks me a series of increasingly strange questions before I make an excuse to take my leave. I didn't even get to brag. Yeah, fine. What do I need to do? Chatty. Yeah, gammon. Let's go talk to Chatty. I return to Chatty with a new lightness. And it makes the weight of my departure feel heavier still. What a strange day. Sable, is that a badge you've got there? Saizo gave it to me. Then you must have earned it. Well done. I give a bow of thanks. Well, Sable, if you keep this up, you'll be headed for the Mask Caster in no time. I tried to think about going to a Mask Caster, but it seems impossibly far away. Imagine choosing what I want to be. Imagine choosing what I want to be forever. I get that, Sable. Choosing what I want to be forever is... Well, that's a daunting choice. I know what you're thinking, but don't worry about it. You'll get plenty of badges when you're out there, and once you've got three alike, you can trade it in for that mask. But don't feel like your first mask is your final choice. The gliding is about freedom and exploration. I suggest you claim as many masks as you wish. Only at your final ceremony will you be asked to choose one. How will I choose one? You'll have to feel it out, but when you know, you'll know. Now. The tone of her now puts the butterflies back in my stomach. With all of this done, there is only one thing left. It's time then, isn't it? Time to walk through the face door at the Temple of Rohana. There, you'll assemble your gliding mask. And go. There are things I wish to convey to Jadi here.
depths of love and gratitude and fear and worry and hope. And though I find myself unable to speak any of it in words, I know she understands. Before you leave, child, I made you these. They are dyed with the traditional Ibexi maroon, and I hope provide you great comfort out in the desert. When you leave today, you will no longer be Sable, clan child of the Ibexi. You will simply be Sable, and the rest will come. But no matter what you are, no matter where your journey takes you, I will always know you, I will always love you, and I will see you again. I don't know where my journey will end, but I know where it must begin, and I am ready. I should head to the temple to begin my gliding. Does that mean I'm not going to be able to come back to this area? Because there are some things around that might pique my interest. Might be something I want to check out. I'm going to make the assumption I can come back to at least check out things. Where's the bike again? Bike is out front. Okay. So we'll take that. We'll head over to the temple, and I think once I get there, that will be good for the stream for today. Yep, turn. There we go. Got some good climbing skills. Almost made it up all the way. Yeah, don't fall off. Okay, it didn't fall off. So I got a glide, I built a new bike that apparently I still can't use quite yet. And now I'm back to the temple. Ooh. Hello. I'll go over to the left here. That looks like a good spot to start. I want to get up to that spot. I'm not sure. Can I get up there? Yes, if I go up this way. Keep climbing. Just keep climbing. Okay, you can stop climbing. Oh, so I need to get onto each one of the platforms and press that to complete the mask so I can go. Ah. So the other one is there, and then this one is over here. Ah. Hmm.
That's the top part. So we're not just doing the mask, we're doing the helmet part too. So I got that there. Okay, so I need to go that direction instead. I like when the music is tranquil like this. It makes it so that as I'm going around, I don't feel much stress about, you know, making particular jumps or efficient routes or stuff like that. Music adds to atmosphere, and that is a mask completed. Yeah, the pink and yellow lights, that might be a theme here. And oh, look, there's the mask. Oh yeah, the character on the box art does have a mask that's more like that than the one that I'm currently wearing. So I gotta go claim it. Where exactly was... Where's the mask again? I know it's floating around somewhere. Is it on this side? Yes, no, maybe so. Where? There it is. Alright. We shall don the mask and return to camp. But actually, we shall not return to camp because I'm going to call it there. And I did have a good time with this, in spite of the one hiccup of the game not spotting the item that I needed. I think it was a lot of fun and pretty peaceful. Thank you for coming to watch. Thanks to Golden for for sticking around with me through this. I appreciate the support. Thank you. I hope that we can get more people next time because, yeah, I think I'm going to continue on with this and we'll see. We'll see exactly when. It might just be next Monday because Mondays are generally free for me and I don't have other things to worry about in that time. But I hope you enjoyed and that you'll join me for the next one. But that is it. I'm gonna save and then head off. Yeah, if you enjoyed and want to join our community over at Cerulean Skies, we have the website. You can follow the Twitter account and the Discord. Join us, chat. There's always something chaotic going on in the Discord. I probably have missed quite a bit of chaos while I've been streaming. And if you want to find me elsewhere beyond Cerulean Skies, my socials are in the banner there. Comrio for Twitter, and then Comrio for YouTube as well. And who knows? Maybe some of this footage will make it into a video at some point if I really enjoy Sable. But yeah, that is it. Thank you all. Have a good night and happy gaming.